Hi, my name's Renner Larson, and I work for the Chicago chapter of the Council on American-Islamic Relations. In the media, we so often see Islam portrayed as this backwards, science-hating, women-oppressing thing, but that's just not true. The Islamic world invented algebra and coffee and marching men. In fact, according to recent research done by a professor of astronomy at Vanderbilt University, Islam is the only one of the three religions that explicitly accepts the possibility of alien life. That's why Anousheh Ansari is the science woman that inspires me, because she's a Muslim woman that defies the stereotype the world has set. Born in Iran in 1966, she immigrated with her family to the United States, where she pursued her passion for science by getting a degree in electrical engineering. After co-founding a wildly successful technologies company, she became on the board of the trustees for the XPRIZE, which in 2004 was renamed the Ansari XPRIZE, because she's that awesome. And if she wasn't already awesome enough, in 2006, Anousheh Ansari fulfilled her lifelong dream of going to space. She became the first not only self-funded woman in space, but the first Muslim woman in space. You've heard of the glass ceiling? Well, how about the glass mesosphere? During her 8-day stay in the International Space Station, she conducted experiments and became the first person to keep a weblog from space. When asked what she hoped to achieve, she replied, "I hope to inspire everyone, especially young people, women, and young girls all over the world, and in the Middle Eastern countries that do not provide women with the same opportunities as men, to not give up their dreams and to pursue them. It may seem impossible to them at times, but I believe they can realize their dreams if they keep it in their hearts, nurture it, and look for opportunities and make those opportunities happen." Anousheh Ansari is a truly inspiring science woman, but in the words of the great LeVar Burton, you don't have to take my word for it.
Those young minds out there, don't let anyone or anything give you any borders or barriers for your imagination. Imagine beyond the possibilities and let your thinking be free. Learn from everything around you and then listen to the voice inside you to tell you what you need to do. And then believe in your imaginations, pursue them, and be the change that would make those imagination into reality in the world. And through what you do, just like what I did, you will be inspiring others, and this will be like a chain reaction that will continue and make this world a better place for all of us.